Sonic just printed its most oversold reading since migrating from Fantom. The token is sitting between 16 to 20 cents, trapped inside a descending channel that's rejected every breakout attempt since May. Most people see a broken chart. I see something different. Over 200 million in USDC just flooded the network. Transaction counts exploded 101% in a week. The ecosystem is compounding quietly while price bleeds. Block times got into 0.4 second zone, making this one of the fastest layer ones in existence. So here's the question. Is Sonic setting up the same way it did back in October when I called the accumulation zone, or is this channel going lower? Let's analyze what the data actually shows. 3 weeks ago, I laid out my Sonic strategy at 16 cents. Price worked exactly as planned, dropping into my 14 to 20 cent load zone. We're now sitting around the same level, right in the middle of that range. The weekly chart looks brutal. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. We're below both exponential moving averages. The descending channel that formed after February's $1 top continues to compress price. Every attempt to break higher has failed. But something shifted in the fundamentals that makes this setup interesting. While most altcoins are getting destroyed, Sonic's ecosystem is accelerating. Real usage is growing. Developer activity is increasing. Infrastructure improvements are landing. The disconnect between price and fundamentals is widening, and that creates opportunity. Whether that opportunity plays out in weeks or months, I don't know. But the risk to reward at current levels deserves attention. Here's why. Let me walk you through what's happening beneath the surface. USDC issuance on Sonic just crossed $200 million. That's an 88% increase in the past month alone. Stablecoins don't flow into dead chains. They flow where people are transacting, trading, and building. This puts Sonic in rare company among Layer 1 networks. Transaction activity tells the same story. Sonic processed 101% more transactions this week compared to the 30-day average. DEX volume hit 123 million. Gas fees remain microscopic at 0.003 cents. 90% of revenue gets shared back to developers. This incentive structure is working. Over 2 million tokens in total app revenue has been generated. 230 active applications are live. 17,000 contracts deployed. The ecosystem isn't just surviving, it's compounding. Then we get to speed. Sonic just hit an average block time of 0.44 seconds. That's a 40% improvement over the 30-day average, making real-time confirmation a practical reality. Compare that to Ethereum's 12 seconds or even Solana's 0.4 seconds. Sonic is competing at the absolute top tier of blockchain performance. Now, not everything is positive. A vocal critic pointed out that if Sonic Labs doesn't step in with treasury support to stabilize price and restore confidence, the chain risks losing momentum. That's a legitimate concern. The token has dropped 90% from $1 to 12 cents this year. Total value locked followed the same trajectory. The migration from Fantom to Sonic didn't go smoothly. Timing coincided with meme coin mania, where serious DeFi projects got ignored. Execution and timing issues hurt adoption. But here's what critics miss. When the Balancer protocol got exploited for $128 million across multiple chains, including Sonic, the network's response was immediate. Sonic froze the attacker's wallet with a single contract call and saved millions. Other chains either halted entirely or let validators censor transactions mid-flight. Sonic's governance moved at the speed of the exploit. That's not failure. That's infrastructure proving itself under pressure. Now let's get into the chart. We're trading at 17 cents on the weekly time frame, sitting inside a descending channel that's been in play since February. This channel has defined price action all year. Right now, the upper trend line sits around 23 cents. That's resistance. The lower support is close to 14 cents, where the last red candle closed. We just tested that level and appear to be bouncing. Price is below both the 10 and 21 period exponential moving averages. The 10 EMA is around 21 cents. The 21 EMA is near 28 cents. Until we reclaim these levels, the trend remains bearish on this time frame. But the distance between current price and these moving averages is creating a rubber band effect. The further we stretch, the more violent the snapback tends to be. Fibonacci retracement gives us targets. I'm measuring from the 90-cent February top down to the recent low of 13 cents. The 236 retracement sits at 30 cents. The 618 sits at 60 cents. These aren't random numbers. They're levels where buyers historically step in or sell. The volume profile confirms this. The point of control, where most trading activity occurred, sits right at 30 cents. Price gravitates toward high-volume nodes. The Heikinashi RSI indicator is deep in oversold territory, pointing downward. Sonic needs a strong green bullish candle to reverse this momentum. But here's what's significant. This is the most oversold reading since the token migration from Fantom to Sonic. Historically, extreme oversold conditions either mark capitulation lows or signal continued weakness. We're at that inflection point now. For my strategy, my load zone remains 14 to 20 cents. I established this range in my October video, and price is working inside it exactly as I wanted. I'm using this zone to accumulate more and lower my average entry. Most of my Sonic was bought around 28 cents earlier this year. Dollar cost averaging here makes sense for my risk profile. My stop loss is a weekly close below the channel. That would invalidate the structure. For the long-term holders, I still view this as an accumulation zone. But if we break the channel, I would look to reaccumulate around 7 cents. That would be the next major support level. Take profit targets are 30 cents, 40 cents, 60 cents, 90 cents, and $1.40 for a moon bag. These align with Fibonacci levels and previous resistance zones. I'm not saying we hit all these targets. I'm saying these are levels where I'll consider taking profits if we get there. Synthesizing fundamentals with technicals, here's what I see. Best case, we hold the channel, reclaim the 21 EMA, and work our way back to 30 cents. That's a near 2x from current levels. If macro cooperates and the ecosystem continues growing, 60 cents becomes realistic. And that's nearly a 4x. Worst case, we break the channel, retest 7 cents, and the ecosystem fails to gain traction. In that scenario, I'm out at the stop and reassessing. Timeline matters. Short term, this looks ugly. The chart is bearish. Momentum is negative. But medium to long term, if you believe infrastructure matters and adoption eventually follows strong fundamentals, current prices offer asymmetric risk reward. The question is whether you have the patience to hold through the ugliness. Sonic sits at 16 cents, deep in oversold territory, inside a descending channel that's compressed price all year. The chart looks broken, but USDC issuance is surging. Transaction counts are exploding. Block times are faster than almost any chain in existence. The ecosystem is compounding while price bleeds. I'm building a position here because the fundamentals keep improving while the chart keeps deteriorating. That divergence interests me. It doesn't mean you should buy. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm sharing my analysis and my strategy. If this breakdown helped you think through Sonic differently, hit the like button. Join my free Telegram group for faster daily updates. Link is in the pinned comment. And if you want the complete playbook on yield strategies I use across DeFi, check out my guide for just $4.99, also pinned below. I recently covered Cody on the channel, also breaking through key levels. Links are on screen if you want more setups like this. And also watch my previous Sonic video.